Hi and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. Today we will be covering spot color channels in Adobe Photoshop CS6. This applies to other versions of Photoshop as well. If you don't already know, spot color channels are used to create reliefs or embossing in images during the print production, as well as adding gold or silver or additional colors to your image. CMYK is a standard four-color process using cyan, magenta, yellow, and black, but sometimes you want to use other colors like maybe a metallic ink to get a gold or a silver, true gold or true silver, that is. So that's what we can use the spot color channels for, and as you might have guessed, they reside in the channels palette. So let's get started. Here we have a king of spades, and if you go back to the layers palette, we can select the area that we want to make gold or silver. In this case, we'll be making it gold. Now, you can use the magic wand, of course, or you can use this method here by selecting based on color range. This can be a little more accurate sometimes and saves a little bit of the hassle of selecting some of the smaller areas. Then I'm going to use the lasso tool and just deselect this centralized area here because all I want is the crowns in this case. Go to your channels palette, create a new spot channel, and then you can select the color that you want. Now we've created an overlay in the channels palette here, and you can see that if you turn off the other channels. It shows up as black, but if you double click on the spot channel layer, you can then adjust the color that's associated with it. Another way to make your selection is to copy into a new layer what you want. Select the area you want with the magic wand, or you can paint in a new area, then press Command J or Control J on the PC to copy it into a new layer. If we do that and then we select all, Command C or Control C to copy, and then we can paste it into a spot color channel, it works a lot like a layer mask. Now in this case it's gone the opposite way of what I was hoping for, so I can press Command I or Control I on the keyboard to inverse this layer, and then that gives me the proper selection I'm looking for. Another option is to use the quick mask. Q on your keyboard and you can paint the area you want to select. That produces a selection, and then we can again create a new spot channel. Now, a very important part of this process not to be overlooked is when you are saving your image. It's important to save your image as a Photoshop DCS 2.0 document. In this way, you create a new document using all of your channel layers. Some document formats do not preserve channel layers, only image layers. So it's important to note that the DCS format will definitely save the channel layers for you. Some TIFF formats do as well, and you'll see here in the DCS format that TIFF is a compression method that can be used. Thanks for joining us for another Photoshop tutorial. This tutorial was brought to you by Innemarata Games at innemaratagames.com. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed.